By the time you're done watching this video, you'll have a mastery of image sizes inside of Midjourney. So when you're using Midjourney, the default sized images that you get are 512 by 512 pixels for the 4x4 grid. Then the first time you upscale this, you get a 1024 by 1024 image. And if you go to max upscale, your image will be 1,664 pixels by 1,664. But you may have seen there is a new beta upscale option inside of Midjourney. And this allows you to upscale your images all the way to 2,048 pixels by 2,048 pixels. So just so you understand where that is, you'll see once you've upscaled an image, there will be a final option here saying beta upscale redo. And this upscales it to a larger size, but it does lose some of the clarity. I will show you how that impacts our images here. So you can see this is the max upscale and it's kept some of these grungy textures on top of the image. But once we've gone all the way up to the beta upscale redo, you can see that it's lost a little bit of those textures. So you do have a higher resolution image, but the details have been sacrificed. Sacrifice the details for size! And just to make sure that you're always getting the largest image that you possibly can, you have to make sure that you click on open original once you've gone into a full screen of your image. This will take you into a new browser tab and you will have the highest possible resolution download possible for your work. So if you want to play around with the aspect ratios inside of Midjourney, then you can use the parameter AR. And to use that, all you have to do is put dash dash AR space followed by the aspect ratio you would like to use at the end of your prompt. So if you're in Midjourney and you put in imagine, a small prompt, sun man, and then you can put in dash dash AR space and then the aspect ratio. For instance, 3x2 will give us a landscape image that has the proportions of 3 along the width axis and 2 along the height axis. So the first number refers to the width and the second number refers to the height. So if you were to change those numbers, if you were to reverse them, you would get the same proportions but in a portrait vertical image. For example, sunman dash dash AR space 2:3. And now we can see that we have our sunman. This is 3x2 and this is 2x3. So the maximum ratio that I found that works inside of Midjourney is 5x2, which is 2.5 times as long as it is high. And it works out at about this sort of size. And the standard that you have in Midjourney is 1x1. So if you then use 5x2 inside of an image, its initial 4x4 grid will be outputted at 1280 by 512. If you upscale it, you then get a 1920 by 768 image, and the image size of that is 2.1 megabytes. And if you upscale to the max, you can get a 2560 image by 1024, and the file size for this one is 3.9 megabytes. And finally, using the upscale beta that we talked about earlier, you can get the biggest image possible, 3200 by 1280. But this is 4.9 megabytes. Now, I have read in the instruction manual for Midjourney, the maximum file size available is 3 megabytes. Now, this does not appear to be true as I have created a number of images that are larger than this. So my understanding is that the instruction manual is a little bit behind where Midjourney is at yet, and it's possible to get files up to 5 megabytes in size inside of Midjourney. So if we compare the 1x1 compared to the 5x2 image, you can see that they actually take up roughly the same surface area. So there's no way to actually increase the amount of space that the image takes up overall. But if you're looking to use your images in high resolution use cases, for example on print or as on some HD background wallpapers, then there is a little secret tip I have for you. There is a wonderful website called letsenhance.io, and what this does is allows you to upscale your images without losing any quality, and it uses what wonderful AI to do that, of course, and it's very simple to use. All you have to do is come to letsenhance.io. You get 10 images upscaled for free before you have to start paying for them, but it is a very reasonable cost for each image if you do start to pay. And to use it, all you have to do is browse your image, select an image, upload it, and by default, it enhances it double. So it makes it twice the size. So this one goes from 2048 pixels all the way up to 4096. But it is possible to increase it even further, but that's can be pushing the limits of this tool. I recommend that you get a very good result in doubling the size. So I'll show you how that works. You just come down and press start processing. And then when that's finished processing, all you have to do is click on it and it will download. Now I'm going to show you. So if you pay for the service, you will remove the watermark. I mean, it's also easy to just blur that out in Photoshop. Not that we would ever do that. And you can see that it has increased its image fantastically well. If we zoom in, I can show you that the details on the upscaled version are much cleaner once you zoom in. So it does a really good job at this. And if we look again here on this example, zoomed in very closely, you can see the upscaled version using AI has increased the detail quite fabulously, and there's no loss of quality within the image. So it's a great tool to use. I highly recommend combining these tools together using Midjourney and our beautiful Let's Enhance. Here is the other one. I'll show you again, compare this, and you can see that it has done a fantastic job upscaling without losing any quality. So there we have it. There's your guide to image sizes inside of Midjourney. It's possible to change the aspect ratio and upscale the images to a larger size using letsenhance.io. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, why not give the like button a whack? Give me a little wacky, wacky, wacky. And leave a comment and tell me what is your favorite prompt. Oh. And check out some other videos. If you like AI art, have a delightful day.